that stars are always related to stellar. Okay, so stellar systems can be multiple, and the other words for stellar is called galaxies.
So
there are. Can you move this? What is your name, Abhi? Can you move this? Why it's showing? Please move this window away from. Okay, thank you. So again, the star is related to stellar system. So that's why it is saying that stellar systems. We cannot put solar because most of the students used to put solar system because they find it out that ye collocation hai to ye chalega. But it cannot be. It cannot be just because of ki solar system sirf ek hai. So system hona chahiye uske liye. Systems you cannot suffix with the solar. So that's why. Okay. And the next one.
The two largest systems. So it cannot be the highest system. So if there is anything which we are talking about, planets or
system,
stars.
System
or
have two categories, smallest or?
And the largest.
Largest, that's it. So, because system has a largest or smallest system, it cannot be highest because we are not measuring any height. System, we cannot measure a height. Okay.
Third one was stretches more than 100,000 light years from one end to another. So that is my key point. So it cannot be like increases. The Andromeda galaxy never increases. So it has to stretch from one end to another.
I'm giving you more word. Pathways. Now add. Pathways and stretches. You have a two words. Now give me the logic. Why SES? Why not a simple word pathway? I'm giving you two words, na pathway, because pathway is almost like a stretches. Pathway and stretches. Now opt this. Which one you're going to opt? Pathway and stretches. You have two words. Forget all.
I still go with stretches only.
Why? Because they have the same meaning. They both have the same meaning.
Pathway, I think it is more related to achieving something.
No. If I have a pathway or stretches, I won't opt. I cannot opt a pathway because always she always needs a plural. The words end with S or ES. So that's why we cannot go for pathway.
So it means you have to use
it means plural. It is a singular, we need a plural. So that's why it is stretches. There is a simple grammar logic. Don't look for any other thing. There is a very simple logic for this.
Okay.
Repeat the logic again.
Where there is a singular, he, she, it, always look for plural. Always. Or where there you have a plural, like they, them, those kind of words, always look for singular. If it replaces with they, then it will become they stretch. But if you have a it over there, then you need a stretches, a kind of words end with S or ES. So that's why I have given Sujanya two things that the two similar words, but one with correct form, another with wrong form. So pathway and stretches. So pathway and stretches is one and same thing because stretches are all about how long I'm passing this stretch. So basically it is all about like we can whenever you are measuring something, if you measure something, then you will measure it in on the earth in kilometers. But when you have to measure the distance between the Earth and Moon, then you will measure it between light years. Light years, the term for measuring a length between, a length between Sun and Moon, or Earth and Moon. So we this thing. But if we need to measure a distance between A point to B point on Earth, we will calculate it in the kilometers. Clear?
Clear. Yep.
Okay. Let's move to the next one. It is very important. So please write it down on your pen and paper. On your notebook, because it is very important. Most of the times you will get such kind of things in the exam. Now there is another beautiful thing you will have in this paragraph. Like it is, yeah. Sujanya, tell me the last one.
It is located.
Why about not positioned? 2 million light. Why not positioned?
Located because it is a distance. Mm-hmm. A distance from, there is a distance, so it has to be located between 2 million light years.
No. It is a dash about 2 million light years from distance from us. Something is locating far away from you. Like if I have to tell myself that this location, like I am locating far away from you. You are at A pole and I'm at B pole. So that means it is a location. When you're talking about position can be changed. That can be moved. But you cannot move a particular city from A point to B point. But positioning can be changed. Getting my point? Positioning can be changed, but location cannot be. If you have a particular location, that is like if a red fort in Delhi is located, we will say it is located. We cannot say it is a position, because positioning can be changed, location cannot be. And there is another logic which I'm giving you, that is grammar based. If you have a pronoun, if you have a pronoun with is, am, are, was, were, be, being, been, always keep in your mind, if you have a pronoun like he, she, it, they, them, those kind of words, and you have a form of helping verbs that are is, am, are, was, were, be, being, always look for superlative degree, third form of verb, always. But if the pronoun is replaced with the noun, if the pronoun is replaced with the noun, if you have is, am, are, was, were, the same kind of helping verb as you have in pronoun, is, am, are, was, were, be, being, been, always it would be verbs first form plus ing. Like Ram is playing, it is played. So it would be like this only. Did you get that?
So if they had mentioned as galaxy is, it would still be located only, right?
It's a locating, because noun, na, galaxy is a noun.
Galaxy is locating.
Okay. Yes. If you have a noun, if you have a noun with is, am, are, was, were, be, being, then you always look for verb plus ing. If you have a pronoun with is, am, are, was, were, be, being, been, always look for verb plus ed. Like played, played, walked. Always. It is a grammar rule. Like Ram eat mangoes. There is another example. Ram eat mangoes. Mangoes are eaten by Ram. Did you know active passive? In the passive case also, the third form of verb will be used when you have a by. There is another hint, and most of the time it is going to reflect in your exam. Most of the time you guys are asking for prediction file, prediction file. Prediction file doesn't work. These things only works for you in the exam, especially in reading fill in the blanks. Because these are the repeated one. The same logic, the same kind of things you're going to get in the exam. And if you have the logic, you can clinch this exam easily, especially reading. Reading is very, very easy. If you do it with techniques and logic, and if you have particular grammar sense, because fill in the blanks is typically based on three aspects. First one is grammar, second one is vocab, and third one is collocation. If you have the knowledge of three, you can easily, very, very easily can solve it. Mark my words. There is another example I'm giving you, which is normally many of the time you will see in PTE reading fill in the blanks. That is noun phrase. Article is there, proper noun is there, common noun is there. Like the Boston Hospital, where there you have an article. Boston is a proper noun. That means proper noun means if you have a particular name, and hospital is a common noun. Hospital could be anyone. So that's why you always need to look for that. Sometime if you have an article, noun is there, you have to opt adjective there. In between both of them. Did you get that?
Yep.
And sometime, one more thing, sometimes verbs act like a noun. Did you know
example?
That? Example, like walking is good for health. Now, if you treat walking is a verb. Walking is a verb, na? So if we use walking as a subject, na, it always will be conducted as a noun. So walking is good for health.
So subject, verb, object, if we have to find in that object is
sometimes you look for that, but problem is that you cannot go in a wide variety of grammar, na? So don't go in a same fashion as Jay used to follow. Subject, verb, object, verb, subject. You're pretty confused. That is very hi-fi thing which is talking about. For people like you, me, and it is difficult to understand what is subject, verb, object, and object, verb, subject. Yes, I have the good knowledge.
We can use that in reorder paragraph only, right?
No, we can use it in fill in the blanks. We can use it in essays. We can use it in anywhere. Where there is English, there could be subject, verb, object, verb, subject. Always.
So, but reorder paragraph, I think it will be more easier than going into all these grammar details, the collocations and everything. So I preferably use that in only in reorder paragraph. The rest grammar, I'll use it in these fill in the blanks.
But is your reading score? Then suggest me.
77.
So that's a pretty good score, but due to the lagging of your speaking somewhere, you're lagging in
speaking 79
plus. That's why I'm telling you, na? You're lagging just because of this speaking read aloud section. So focus on that as well.
बाकी सब में 77 77 77 है, सिर्फ स्पीकिंग 70, सो दैट इज व्हाई आई एम स्केयर्ड टू गिव अनदर वन. Even if one mark goes, then you have to write again. So
I know that you have a, like, somehow people are facing the problem. Why other are keep shut their mouth and listening to only both of us? Because other are not interested to get to know us. Hello, guys.
Sir, are you getting my voice?
Yes, I am.
Manish this side, sorry to interrupt you, cut you. The thing is, I am also preparing for PTE. I have a query. Can I put it here now?
Please, sir.
Thank you. Thanks to allow me. So the thing is, I have given the PTE exam twice in the last 1 month. Mm-hmm. So in my first attempt, my score was 81 each in listening and writing. Mm-hmm. And my 82 in speaking, I was 83. Mm-hmm. But in reading, my score was 75. Mm-hmm. Okay, so then I again prepared for, when I observed, I got to know that somewhere I am lacking with read aloud. This was my personal, observation. So
I'm telling you straightforward that you are lacking in read aloud. And somewhere around, your reading fill in the blanks is not up to the mark.
Yeah, okay, sir.
Because, सी मैं अभी एक चीज बताता हूँ आप लोगों को. बहुत सारे लोगों को अभी तक ये ही नहीं पता होगा कि रीड अलाउड से हमें कितने स्कोर आते हैं और राइटिंग से हमें कितने स्कोर हमें रीडिंग में जा रहे हैं और लिसनिंग से कितने स्कोर हमें जा रहे हैं. बिकॉज इसका भी एक सेशन लूंगा मैं. आई विल कंडक्ट दिस सेशन टुमारो, डे आफ्टर टुमारो. आई विल लेट यू नो दैट ईच एंड एवरी थिक एंड थिन अबाउट द पीएसएन कि कहां से हम ज्यादा से ज्यादा स्कोर ट्रिगर आउट कर सकते हैं. बिकॉज अभी रीड अलाउड अगर आप मानकर चलो तो 30 पॉइंट्स हम रीडिंग में मिलते हैं हमें अप्रोक्सीमेटली. लगभग इसलिए कह रहा हूं, अगेन दीज फिगर्स आर नॉट फॉर श्योर, दीज आर हाइपोथेटिकली प्रोवाइडेड फिगर्स. बिकॉज इसका कारण क्या है कि जैसे अब हम रीड अलाउड की बात करते हैं तो पियर्सन ने, अगर आपने ध्यान से पढ़ा हो, पियर्सन इटसेल्फ सेज कि फाइव ऑफ प्रोनंसिएशन, फाइव ऑफ फ्लुएंसी, बट वो कंटेंट को डिस्क्राइब नहीं करता है.
राइट,
कंटेंट को हाँ, तो वो कहता है कि आपको लेंथ ऑफ द कंटेंट. सॉरी, यप.
Yeah, hi, this is Manikandan. Actually, can you speak in English, please?
Sorry. Actually, the other people are in Hindi Bhashi, so just because of I carried away. So, my apology.
Yeah, okay. It's fine, actually. I'm just following, but missed the last bit of the part.
Okay. The thing is that when you talk about this thing like read aloud, the read aloud part is very crucial in terms of if you are looking for good score in reading, because each reading read alouds secure 15 points approximately. Because we cannot say we can say that 5 for fluency, 5 for pronunciation, that is confirmed. Okay, so Manish, is it correct? Yeah. Na? So
yes,
but they, for the content, they are not fixing it,
right?
Because they are saying that the words length, the word number of words may vary. So just because of,
yeah.
But my gut point says that they are not going to cross it beyond 5 points.
Okay.
They are not going to cross it more than 5 points, because in the describe image, they are giving 5 points for content. In the written lecture, they are giving 5 points for your content. Is it right or not? Did you check that? They mentioned that they are going to give you 5 points for content in describe image, 5 points for written lecture. So that's why my understanding says that they are not going to get it cross this bar. They are going to fix this. And if we take a hypothetical figure, we talk about a read aloud section. So read aloud going to give you 30 points for reading section. But how much for your speaking? The speaking section would now will have 90 points. 90 points for your speaking and 30 points for your reading points. So total becomes how much? 120. So if you figure out 30 points, then you can easily grab that. But if you don't, then you are going to mess with that. Because number of time I have seen, there are lots of scorecard came across to me and they used to ask me, please tell us, sir, that where did I lag behind? So my simple response to them is that, please analyze yourself. Give me a sheet where you have to write a positive of yours and negative of yours during the exam. Because on that basis, I can give you 100% remedies. Because you are the master, my dear friend. You can tell me your weak areas. Because you have performed in the exam. On the basis of your scorecard, I can only assume. Am I right or not? I can only assume. I can give you the prediction that it has happened, or maybe this has happened, but the exact idea only can provided by you.
Yeah.
No one can ask.
Sir, I have one more question. May I ask?
Yes, please. Yes, please.
Now thing is, that was score of my first attempt. Now on last Saturday, 2 days ago, I again, gave the test. That was my second attempt. So okay. My scorecard was, in my first attempt, my listening and writing were 81 each. So in okay. second attempt, they were 82 each. Okay. But now the negative point is, in my first attempt, my speaking was 83. Then which drastically reduces to 75 in my second attempt. And because of that, my reading was also 73 this time, which was earlier 75. So what I concluded it like when I was giving the test in my speaking section, in read aloud, I am pretty much sure it has done because the major damage.
I can correlate that because your voice is not clear, my dear friend. Sorry to like this, but yeah. As far as whatever I can hear you, your words are not clear to the machine just because of your lagging behind in the read aloud section, and you due to your throat constraint, you are not clear to the machine. Because yes, ultimately,
that was my weakest point. Yeah.
Because many of the time I used to tell the students that there are two types of error. In my previous lecture, I used to tell the students that there are two types of errors. One is conscious error, the second is unconscious error. Then people used to ask me, it's a strange, you're telling us that no one tell us in the future. In the previous, no one tell us that it is there are two types of error, and it's a strange if we are listening from you. So I used to tell them that, see, when you're reading consciously, normally it has happened, and many of the students does this. If you are not doing, you're exception. But many of the times students, when reading consciously, they used to do the mispronunciation, fumbles, addition or deletion of word, along with that false start, and umming and ahhing, kind of. And most of the time students have the kind of mindset that they have to speak in very fast pace. If you are speaking on a very fast pace, that means you are clinching the fluency.
Right.
But Pearson never mentioned that. Even if you speak on a fast pace, you are going to mess with your words.
Sir, my problem is, what I have observed is I know my fluency is good, and I don't fumble in between read aloud. I pronounce each and word correctly, but somewhere I think the clarity is missing in my words. That's why the computer in Pearson test, it is not, getting the words correctly. This is my observation. Because of that, in this exam, second attempt, my pronunciation was only 64.
Yes.
Earlier, it was 79.
Yes, it has happened. Many of the time, students are facing this problem, and especially with you, as far as I can observe you, I can listen to your voice. Sometime if I'm hearing you, you're doing, your word clarity is missing somewhere. Because your throat is not permitting you to speak as much as clear. But there are certain remedies you can take it, and you can clear your throat. I will suggest to you, once I'll finish the session, I'll let you know the speaking part in which that you will, how you can improve your this kind of problem. I have 100%.
Yes, please.
I will suggest to you. You need not to worry.
Because apart from this, I know I can score more than 79 because in my other sections it is there. And I know my other sections are not weak. But this time you're going to do this.
Definitely.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
I will suggest you remedies. You need not to worry.
Yeah, please. Thank you so much.
Okay, brother. Okay. So where we are. So Janya. Sorry, it was a long discussion. So just because of you missed that part. So anyways. Okay. So the third one, planted, blows, overwhelming, pay, urban. So how many of you have corrected? I believe Sujanya,
I got four.
Okay, planted, blows, overwhelming, pay, urban. Now, whatever the example I have given for that, now the noun plus SMR, ing, and you all have done the same mistakes. Maybe where you were wrong.
Mine is only wrong in the third one. It says hang around ozone is the important factor.
Yes. Yes, I know that. Because I know that you made a mistake just because of, as I told you earlier, that where there is a noun. Ozone is a noun. Mm-hmm. You have a SMR. Is this there? Now you have a. What should be there? Did you write somewhere what I told you?
Yes. Noun plus is verb plus ing.
Yes. So that's the issue. That's why, again, I'm telling you, whatever the things I'm telling you, it is going to constantly repeating in the exam. And if you have the techniques, such kind of techniques, you can easily crack this. Because these are very easier ones. Okay, now tell me, why did you opt planted? Why not grown? Because both are the third form of verb. Now, give me the reason.
Okay, so I didn't see grown at all. I only saw planted in the first.
Okay.
So, first sentence says grows. So I thought the grown again would not come.
Yes, and I didn't see good. Bravo. Good.
So I thought
because
like the
it's not grow. It's a grew.
Grew. Yeah. No, I didn't see the word grown at all. But since I read the first sentence, the tree grows. So that means it's already grown. It is already planted. So I thought outside a small town substrate, there should be something which is already planted. That's why it is already grown.
Mm-hmm. Planted so is right.
Is how I work.
Planted is right. Because have is there.
I think in the second line also, the same sentence it says, the other city pots grew to double the biomass.
Biomass.
Of clones planted
yes,
outside.
Yes. So third form of verb is required because grew is already there, so we cannot go for grown. So, so that's why. Okay, cool. The next one.
Second one was blows in and lingers.
There is one more trick I'm going to give you guys. Where there is a that, always look for verb. Normally that verbs end with s or es. Okay, I'm going to disconnect and connect. Excuse me guys, I have to disconnect and reconnect once again because this is a 40 minute session and this is going to complete. All of a sudden it is going to disconnected. So before this, I'm disconnecting and connecting once again, so please don't leave.
Okay.